YouTube, welcome to the Movie Bay. My name is D, and I'll be hosting this channel. This is a new channel. This is my first video on this channel. Well, it's not my first video on this channel. I'm actually renamed the channel. I was doing a little bit of tech here and there in the beginning, but now I decided to go ahead and dedicate the channel to just doing movies, movie reviews, unboxings, and pickup videos because I love collecting physical media. A lot of you do too. So we're going to have fun enjoying what we love to do, collect physical media. Now, a lot of people have us believe that our physical media is dead, is not relevant anymore. Why collect DVDs? They're not really worth anything. They're not worth anything to you, but in the secondhand market, guys like me, we do very well collecting this used media. People are selling DVD and Blu-ray collections by the boatload. If you don't believe me, go look on eBay. Look on OfferUp, look on Let Go, look on Craigslist, look everywhere. Even little media stores, the mom and pop little media stores, they're overflowing with DVDs and Blu-rays, overflowing. And guys like us, we can go in and clean up, okay? You got a lot of online resellers who are reselling used movies. Second Spin is probably the biggest. FYE, they have a great used business. FYE is nice because you can do new or used. I don't know why you would buy a new movie unless you are that kind of collector. Now, I know there's a lot of collectors who strictly collect the higher end stuff like Criterion, Steelbooks, and things like that. So there's a market for everyone. And this, and what we do, I'm not going to call it a trade or anything, but in collecting, there's a lot of different type of collectors. Me, I'm a title collector. I just want the title. If it's a stripped down version with not a whole lot of special features, I'm totally fine with that if the price is right. Long as the movie looks good, it's the full movie. It still book, no book. I do enjoy slip covers for the Blu-rays, but again, if it doesn't have the slip cover, not a problem. I'll still buy it if the price is right. So I'm not really a picky or a finicky collector. I just really want the title, and I still buy DVDs. Nowadays, I buy more Blu-rays, but I still do buy DVDs. Depending on the movie. Now, for me, since I collect both DVDs and Blu-rays, in order for me to pony up the extra couple bucks for the Blu-ray version of a movie, it would have to be a movie that I really, really like. Every movie I buy does not have to be on Blu-ray. For example, this original It movie, it looks great on DVD. It's an older movie. Now, would it benefit from the 4K bump? I mean, the Blu-ray bump? Sure. But it looks great just like this. If I saw both of them in the store and the Blu-ray was just maybe a dollar or two more, I would buy the Blu-ray. But if the Blu-ray was $5 to $10 more, I'm going to buy it on DVD. That's just me, though. That's the kind of collector I am. I like movies. And DVD is still a very viable option for me. I know for a lot of guys, they won't touch a DVD. Certain movies, I'm going to just name one real quick. This movie is by Stephen King. This is an older movie. It's called Needful Things. It's a really good movie. Now, if you look at this movie now, it might look a little cheesy. The story is really good. It's cheesy. It's hard to explain this movie because it's cheesy, but it's good. Stars Ed Harris is the lead in this movie, and I forget the bad guy's name. I forget. He's a popular old school actor, very charming in this movie, the character he played. I'm not going to give you any spoilers or anything in case you haven't seen this movie. I know a lot of people seen this movie, but I know a lot of people did not see this movie. This is an example of a movie that is expensive. It's hard to find, okay? So I don't think it's out of print. I don't think so. And the reason why I don't think it's out of print is because they did do a Blu-ray release on this. And it might be out of print, okay? But it's expensive on DVD and Blu-ray. If you go on eBay right now and type in Needful Things, the DVD version, you wouldn't be surprised if you saw it as high as 25 bucks. This one was 12 bucks. And to me, on a used market for a DVD, 12 bucks is expensive. But I wanted this title in my collection. I saw this. Sorry about the light glare, guys. I saw this movie years ago when I first started collecting, but I never put it in my collection because, again, I bought a lot of my movies used. Now, I did buy some new, but a lot of movies got slipped right past my radar because I wasn't able to find them used. And this is one of them. This was never in my collection. I just recently added this to my collection about a month ago. And it was 12 bucks on eBay. Now, to me, that's expensive, but after doing the research and looking for this movie and seeing all the different prices, I realized that $12 was a good price to pay for this movie. So if you can, find this movie for a good price and add it to your collection. You won't be sorry. It's a really good movie, and it's rare. It's very hard to find. So this is an example of a DVD that I wouldn't mind adding to my collection, being a DVD, and paying a few dollars more for it than my normal. I'll be honest with you guys. As a collector, I'm a little bit of a cheapskate. I try to keep my purchases down to about $4 to $5 for DVDs. Actually, less than that for DVDs. I try to keep the DVDs down to about $2.50, $3. That's what I try to keep them at. A lot of the mom and pop stores will sell you DVDs. I got one store that I go to this in my neighborhood. He sells DVDs $5 for $10. $5 for $10. So that's the price that that's a good price for DVDs for me. That's $2.50 a movie. That's great. Now, there's another store that I go to. He has a really awesome selection. He's a little bit more organized, so it's easier to find what you want there. You'll pay a little bit more. His DVDs average $4 to $5 a piece. With the other guy, you may have to do a little bit more searching. He's not as organized, and he don't have the selection that the other guy has, but he's cheaper, so he's 5 for 10 for DVDs. So whenever I want some DVDs, I go there. He also has Blu-rays. His Blu-rays is a good price, too. His Blu-rays are 2 for 8. So he got some really good price on his Blu-rays. Again, it's another store that I deal with that got better selection. I think he pays more for his trades. When people come to sell DVDs and Blu-rays, I think he pays out more, so he gets the better movies than the guy who's cheaper. Because he's cheaper, he pays less for a new inventory coming in. So his selection isn't that good, because I was going to sell to him, but he didn't offer me enough. He tried to offer me like $7 for like 30 movies, 30 DVDs that I have recently upgraded to Blu-ray, and I was not going to let them go. I took them to the other store and got, at least I was looking for a dollar for each one, to be honest with you, because I know they're not really worth a lot, and the guy got to make a living too. So to me, fair was a dollar, maybe $1.50, hell, even $2, depending on the movie. Okay, I'll be honest with you, depending on the movie, average a dollar, I'll let them go for a dollar each after I already upgraded them to Blu-ray. That just covers some of my costs. That's all it was for me. So yeah, on this channel, we're going to be discussing collecting Blu-rays, DVDs. I love it. We're going to have lots of fun. We're going to do movie night. I'm going to give movie night suggestions to you guys. Now, again, that's just going to be my opinion, because everybody's taste in movies is different. I hope that when you come by and you look at some of my movie night suggestions, you say, whoa, I never heard of that movie before. Hey, I never saw that movie before. Or you know what? I haven't seen that movie in a long time. I think I'm going to go out and try to get that movie. We'll talk about places to buy movies from. There's a lot of places to buy used movies from now. For people who buying brand new movies, I get it. Trust me, I get it. But for those of us who don't want to spend $15, $20 on a movie that we might watch once or twice, or we might not, we let it sit on the shelf for 6 months, a year before we watch it again, I can understand you not wanting to spend $15, $20, $30 on a movie. If you look at some of the Marvel releases, they are outrageous when they first come out. And they are even outrageous in the used market. That's why I don't have a lot of Marvel titles in my collection just yet, because the prices are still very high. Now, what I do, if I do want some Marvel releases, Second Spin is a great place to buy your Marvel releases, because they have sales all the time. They might have a buy two, get one. Buy three, get one. They might have 20% off or 30% off. That's the one right there. You can load up your cart with some Marvel releases and save a boatload. eBay, you can find some Marvel releases. You can just sift through the different sellers. You might get lucky, but for example, Doctor Strange, which was an okay Marvel movie for me. That movie is very expensive. It's over $20 on almost every seller on eBay. So that's why it's not in my collection just yet. Marvel movies, I am willing to budge a little bit and spend maybe $10 on them on Blu-ray. I'm willing to go as high as $10 for them, and I'm quite sure I find them, because I have a few. And I just take my time and just wait to find them for the price that I'm willing to spend. And that's another thing with collecting, guys. When you're collecting, you're trying to build your collection, you got to keep a budget. You have to be budget-minded, because if you spend top dollar for all your movies, you're going to spend a lot of money on your movies. And you don't have to. In the used market, you really don't have to. Now, if you got an itch for a movie and you just got to have it, you may pony up a little bit more, where if you just waited a little bit, you can just probably find it. You can actually put feelers out. What I mean by feelers is you can go to like eBay and just probably type in what you want to pay, and eBay will keep an eye out for it, and they'll alert you when it's at the price you want to pay, and they'll take you right to the seller. eBay does that, and I think there's an actual app, like a price matching app, where you can just type in what you want to pay for something, and Google might even do it, where you could just type in what you want to pay for something, give it a parameter, and it'll alert you when that particular movie is in that parameter, and you can go ahead and buy it. So you don't even have to keep searching back and forth. But that's all I really have for this video. This is an introduction to my channel. This is like a relaunch. This channel was called, what did I call this channel? I started this channel a long time ago, then I stopped, and I started another YouTube channel called The Shooter's Bay, which is still active. I haven't put any videos over there in a while, but this is The Movie Bay. This channel is my movie channel. I have a firearm channel called The Shooter's Bay, where I go by the name of Cooter the Shooter. So you can go over there and check out if you like, if you're into firearms, and I do some technology over there too, some unboxing. I do a few gadgets here and there, but it's more about firearms and things of that nature. So that's something else that I'm very fond of too. But over here, this is strictly movies and entertainment. We're going to talk about movies. We're going to actually review movies. Not a whole lot of new stuff that's going to be going on this channel. I'm just going to be reviewing a lot of movies that's already out. We're going to be talking about them. We're going to be doing comparisons. If I go to the movie theater and check out a new film, I'll come back and do a review. We'll discuss it. We're just going to have fun. Look forward to the movie night video where I give you guys my movie night picks. My next video, I'm going to do my second spin. I just picked up quite a few films from Second Spin, and I'm going to do an unboxing on Second Spin. The next two videos is going to be the Second Spin unboxing, and we're going to go over the CLZ movie app. That's a really nice app for cataloging your collection. It's available on iOS and Android, and they also have a PC version. I'll go through all the features, and we'll just have fun talking about that. And I hope to see you in the next video. If you like, share, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. I'm D. I'll see you in the movie bay.